Thank you. This is the message we have heard from Jesus and now proclaim.
That God is light, and in the universe is the darkness of all.
If we say that we have fellowship with Him while we are walking in darkness,
we lie and do not do what is true.
But if we walk in the light as He Himself is in the light,
we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, His Son, cleanses us from all sin.
If we say that we have no sin,
we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us.
If we confess our sins,
He who is faithful and just will forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
If we say that we have not sinned,
we make Him a liar, and His word is not in us.
God's word made flesh, Jesus, has declared that the greatest commandment of God's word, indeed the summation of all the law and all the prophets, is to love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and all your strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself. We have failed to keep this word of love, and for this we make confession to our God. Lord, your word says love is patient, and love is kind.
When we confess the times when we have failed to wait on you, and have been patient with each other, when we have been bitter toward you, and not kind to each other.
Jesus, word of love,
hear us, we pray.
Your word tells us that love does not envy, that it does not boast, and that it is not proud.
But we confess that sometimes we have been resentful toward you and envious of each other. We have been self-promoting toward you and neglectful of each other. We have been indignant with you and demeaning toward each other.
Jesus, word of love,
forgive us, we pray.
The word says that love is not rude, and that it is not self-seeking.
But we confess that in many ways we have been demanding toward you, and inconsiderate of those around us, denying of you, and indifferent of each other.
Jesus, word of love,
forgive us, we pray.
Your word tells us that love is not easily angered, and that it keeps no record of wrongs.
But we confess how often we are angry with you and snap at each other, how self-justifying we are with you, and how unforgiving we are toward each other.
Jesus, word of love,
forgive us, we pray.
Your word says that love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth, that it always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres.
But we confess how often we have surrendered to you, moving silently to face of evil, abandoning your truth, all to the denial of trust, hope, and endurance for those who struggle in our midst.
Jesus, word of love,
forgive us, we pray.
Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, does not desire the death of sinners, rather that they may turn from their wickedness and live. We who have been baptized into Christ Jesus have been baptized into His death. Just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, thus are we to live a new life. We implore Him to grant us true repentance and His Holy Spirit, that those things may please Him which we do in this life, that the rest of our days may be pure and holy, and at the last we may come to His eternal joy. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you. And as they led him away, they seized one Simon of Cyrene, who was coming in from the country, and laid on him the cross to carry it behind Jesus. And there followed him a great multitude of the people, and of women who bewailed and lamented. But Jesus, turning to them, said, "Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me, but weep for yourselves and for your children. For behold, the days are coming when they will say, 'Blessed are the barren, and the wombs that never bore, and the breasts that never gave suck.' Then they will begin to say to the mountains, 'Fall on us,' and to the hills, 'Cover us.' For if they do this when the wood is green, what will happen when it is dry? Two others also, who were criminals, were led away to be put to death with him. And when they came to the place which is called the Skull, there they crucified him, and the criminals, one to the right and one to the left. And Jesus said, 'Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do.' And they cast lots to divide his garments."
Now from the sixth hour there was darkness over all the land until the ninth hour. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani?" That is, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" And some of the bystanders hearing it said, "This man is calling Elijah."
After this, Jesus, knowing that all was now finished, said, to fulfill the scripture, "I thirst."
It was now about the sixth hour, and there was darkness over the whole land until the ninth hour, while the sun's light failed, and the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Then Jesus, crying with a loud voice, said, "Father, into thy hands having said this, he breathed his last.
A bowl full of vinegar stood there. So they put a sponge full of the vinegar on his hand and held it to his mouth. When Jesus had received the vinegar, he said, "It is finished." And he bowed his head and gave up his spirit. Thank you. Lord, remember us in your kingdom.